guys, so after a long time I'm making a video. So there's a very quick piece of advice I want to share with you guys. Before that, I broke my phone. It is broken badly. It fell on road and it broke. It had tempered glass, but why it broke? Because it fell on a little piece of rock and the rock hit it here only, and that's how the crack started. So then I had to buy a new phone at 7 Plus, which I have, and I'm recording from it. Happy. So the piece of advice that I want to share with you is, it's something I have actually experienced myself. And trust me, you are going to relate to it. So we have this habit of asking for help or, you know, advices whenever we are in trouble or facing any kind of issue in our lives. And what we end up doing is, whatever advice we have gotten from people or suggestions, we end up implementing the same without even giving it a thought. Or maybe even if we are giving it a thought, we would end up doing the same. Why? It's their perception who are suggesting to us. Yes, of course they are trying to help us, but still it's their perception. It's what they think. It's what they might have done. It's not even certain if they were in the same situation, they would end up doing the same. They could have done something else. Then why are you taking their suggestion up so quickly and implementing it on your own problem, where you are understanding what if situation you are going through, only you know it better. The other person knows the story that you are telling. It could be different from the real situation. Sometimes we miss something and the person only understands what you are narrating. So you have to understand one thing. When there is any problem, it comes between two people. You cannot have a problem with machinery, right? That can be sorted. So when there is a problem between two people, they should be the one sorting it out, not the third person. But then also, when you're going to another person for any kind of help, suggestion or advices, they will tell you their own perception and vision. You don't need to follow that. If you do that, you will always end up screwing. Always, mark my words. I've done that entire life and I have suffered enough for that. Even if I have problem in workplace or any small thing, because I have this thing that I like to discuss and then decide what to do. So I end up doing what people are suggesting me. And then I realize, oh my God, I have actually screwed it up, because whatever I thought could be done was better. But still, I did it wrong way. So after analyzing the situation, I finally have decided not to do that ever, because it screws things up. Suppose, see, you are living a life which only you know how, you know, you have managed things, done things, how you're getting your things done in a right way. How someone else can understand it better than you? So whatever you think, whatever you know, whatever you feel is the perfect answer. Also, sometimes you need to give yourself a break and, you know, just let it go for a while. Okay, take that pain for a while and then analyze the situation. And it's good to share, but analyze the situation, take the advices, think from all the perspective, then form your decision. It's not like analyze the situation, take advice and implement it. That's the wrong way and you're going to suffer it. And if you can relate to it, you will understand what I'm trying to tell you here. This happens, you know, whenever we are so puzzled and in problem, we would call our friends and we would tell them, because the friend who is listening is relaxed. So he would tell you what he casually thinks, or maybe, you know, what according to him or her should be done. But you are puzzled. So you would just hear all that and you will think, oh yeah, this could be the thing. Oh, I missed on that. Oh, I should do this. But that's wrong. Again, there are 7 billion people. They all have their own vision, perception. When all the faces are different, how can you think all the visions and, you know, the way of thinking could be same? So everyone has their own unique way of expressing, thinking and implementing things. So whatever you are doing is the best for you, and whatever you think should be done for you is the best for you. So do whatever you think, take advices, we discuss and we share, because we need to understand what other people might have done if they go through the same situation, not because we want to do what others would have done or could have done, want to do, whatever. So understand the difference between this and you'll be sorted for life. At least there will be, you know, one less problem in your life that you're taking advice, but you're not blindly implementing or following it. All right. And I'm glad that I have realized this thing, and I'll always, you know, I take advice, then I think, and then I do it. And there are people who actually give you what's required, you know, bang on advice. So that's a different thing. It's not like out of all the 100 situations, you have to do whatever you think is the best. There are times when the other person's suggestions are better than yours. That decision you have to form again. The person will not going to tell you that, you know, follow my advice because my advice is the best. That decision has to be formed by you. Why I should do this and how I should do this, not the way he is or she is telling you. So that's it for today. That's a little piece of advice that you should definitely take, okay? It's not like that. I'm giving you something for, you know what I mean? Okay, I don't want to mess it up because I do that a lot in my videos. And that's it. Recorded in one shot. I'm happy. Back again. Ta-da! Okay, now I should actually stop it. Okay, guys. Bye-bye.